Whoa, PPE.
I'm so sorry.
Hello, Sam. Did you forget something? We have something to show you. Come learn with us. Personal protective equipment, aka PPE.
Hello, I'm Miss Doffing.
And I'm Miss Doffing.
Has the whole PPE thing got you confused, anxious, panicky?
Not sure if you're doing it right.
Well, don't worry. We've got you covered.
Ready to start?
Yeah.
Number one, always put on PPE before you enter the patient care area.
And make sure to select the right PPE based on the infectious agent or situation.
And the right size for you.
But first, perform hand hygiene before donning any PPE.
Now it's not hard, just follow me.
Put the gown on by sliding it up your arms. Insert your thumbs into the thumb inserts of the gown, if it has them. This gown has a loop that can be placed over your head. Next, secure the gown by tying the ties in the back.
The procedure for putting on and removing gowns should be tailored to the specific type of gown. For reusable gowns with snaps or ties, ensure they are fastened at the back of the neck and waist.
For droplet precautions, don a face mask. And for airborne precautions, don a respirator. Sam, you put on a mask. If the mask has loops, they go over your ears. Stretch the bottom of the mask underneath the chin and form it to your nose. If you have a patient on airborne precautions, you will need a respirator. Make sure to get a fit test for the respirator to ensure a correct seal. Make sure the straps are not tangled. Then, place the respirator over your mouth and nose. Make sure the metal piece is on your nose. Take the top strap and place it just past the top of your head above the ears. Take the bottom strap and place it around the bottom of your head. Make sure the straps are not overlapping. Form the metal piece to your nose and perform the seal test. Blow the air out and feel with your hands if it's escaping. If it does, work the metal piece a little more or get refitted for a different respirator. Next, put on eye protection. And lastly, don gloves. Make sure the gloves cover the edge of the sleeves and that there is no exposed skin at the wrist. All set? Victory dance! Go get 'em, Tiger.
All right, Ms. Wilson, I'll be right back.
Now it's my turn. Let's doff.
Always remove PPE before leaving the patient care area.
However, if you're wearing a respirator, remove it after you leave the patient care area.
Remember, this is very important. The outside of the gloves, eye protection, mask, as well as the front of the gown are contaminated.
This can make doffing a little tricky. To minimize chances of contamination, don't touch the outside of the PPE items with ungloved hands while removing your PPE.
If you accidentally touch the contaminated area, perform hand hygiene immediately.
First, remove gown and gloves. And here is one of the recommended best practices for doffing gown and gloves. It's the one-step method.
First, grasp the gown at the front and pull away from your body to tear the ties at the neck. Then, grasp it again a little lower to tear the ties at the back. Make sure to keep your hands on the outside of the gown. While removing the gown, fold or roll the gown inside out, away from the body, and into a bundle. As you are removing the gown, peel off your gloves at the same time by first releasing one hand and then the other. Place the gown and gloves into a waste container. Again, try not to touch the contaminated areas with ungloved hands while removing PPE. Next, if you're wearing single-use eye protection, remove and dispose.
If you're using reusable eye protection, disinfect the eyewear after each patient encounter in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions.
Last, remove the mask, grasp the ear loops, lift over the ears, and discard into a waste container. When you're finished,
perform hand hygiene.
You got it.
Let us also show you how to remove reusable gowns. For reusable gowns, the order of doffing is slightly different. First, remove gloves and perform hand hygiene. Then, remove goggles or face shield. Unfasten gown ties or snaps, taking care that sleeves don't contact your body when reaching for ties. Pull the gown away from the neck and shoulders, touching the inside of the gown only. Turn the gown inside out, fold or roll into a bundle, and place into a designated receptacle for reprocessing. Next, remove the mask or respirator. And last, hand hygiene. Now, let's go through the steps of doffing the respirator. A respirator is used if you have a patient on airborne precautions. Always remove a respirator after exiting the patient's room and always perform hand hygiene upon exiting. Remember, the front of the respirator is contaminated, so without touching the respirator, pull the bottom strap over the back of the head. Then pull the top strap over the head. Discard in the waste container. The last step is to perform hand hygiene after doffing the respirator. Just like that. Great job.
There's one more thing we want to show you, and that's the proper way to remove gloves by themselves. To remove gloves, first start with your non-dominant hand. Pinch the other glove around the cuff in the wrist area and peel it off by turning it inside out. Roll it into a ball with the gloved hand. Now, take the index finger of the ungloved hand and slide it under the cuff of the gloved hand. Peel the glove off the hand by pushing the finger forward. The glove will turn inside out. You should now be holding the balled gloves, but only touching the inside of the gloves. And then, of course,
hand hygiene.
Questions?
No, I'm good. Thanks, twins. I gotta be off to the next patient.
We've shown you simple step-by-step procedures for donning and doffing PPE.
Make sure to follow the right sequence, especially for doffing, to avoid contamination.
Practice it every day and always make sure to follow the procedures set by your facility's protocols.
Close attention to PPE protocols and signage is vital to keeping you, your patients, and your coworkers safe and healthy.